This is Alan Bush with the Daily Financial Forecast for Thursday, June 7th. Stock index futures putting in a good performance, at least in the overnight trade, with the NASDAQ and Russell 2000 futures both advancing to new record highs. Even though we do have the ongoing geopolitical problems, stock index futures performing very well. No major economic reports scheduled for today. Also, I'd have to say that with the indices performing I would have to say better than the news would suggest over the last few days as far as economic reports. Strength in indices suggests that something bullish is likely to come into this market, possibly in the form of a better trade situation, maybe lessened trade tensions around the world. But to one degree or another, something bullish is in the works, and higher stock index futures appear to be reflecting that outlook. Moving over to the currencies, the dollar index coming under some pressure and the euro currency advancing to a three-week high. Much of this strength in the euro currency linked to the belief that the upcoming European Central Bank policy meeting could produce a debate involving the possibility of ending the quantitative easing program by the end of this year. So that would imply higher interest rates or at least less accommodation, and that of course is supportive to the euro currency and bearish to the US dollar. My feeling is that the ECB does want to withdraw some of this accommodation. Also, we are seeing the British pound trading just a little bit lower with some negative economic news there. Interest rate markets coming under some pressure yesterday with flight to quality longs being liquidated in light of a better tone to the US-China trade situation. More of a mixed session today. Probability of a rate hike at the June 13th meeting at 94%, same as yesterday. Still believing that, though, that any flight to quality buying that comes along for whatever reason should be viewed as a selling opportunity, since the dominant trend, the main trend, still appears to be lower, as the Fed still likely to raise rates two times this year. Some analysts saying three. I'm only going to go with two, possibly two or three more rate hikes next year. So the fundamentals remain bearish longer term for the credit markets. So good trading, everyone. And once again, remember, these are my opinions alone and are not the opinions of ADMIS or Archer Daniels Midland.